What's going on, team? Happy Big Friday. It's a bit of a special Big Friday today because I've got someone coming to watch me lift that has never seen me lift before, which you're probably gonna find quite amusing. You're about to meet my mum, kids. So this is my mum, YouTube. Mum, what was I like as a kid?
Always ambitious, always ambitious. From the age of 5, I think he said he wants to get on the Olympic stage, wants to do it once only. Done it.
There
always,
you go.
Always been an achiever, but worked hard, worked hard.
And you've never seen me lift before, Mum?
No, I've never seen him lift before.
So you don't know what happens on this very special day of the week, but I go full send. So we're gonna throw some sick weights around for my mum, try and impress her a little bit, try and not get her to have a heart attack while I nearly snap myself doing a big lift.
Yeah.
But she's over because it's Mother's Day this Sunday. Shout out to any mothers. This will probably be after Mother's Day that you guys get to see this, but big love, mothers. Come on, time to warm up.
You're getting a little bit of anxiety because last time you saw him lift, he hurt his elbow.
No, that was on a swing. He was trying to go higher than his mum when he was about, oh no, he wouldn't have been any more than about 7. See, watch me, mum, jump down. I'm still trying to stop the swing because I was going, no, Sonny, no. And then he stood up and his arm was literally like that.
I've still got the scar from it. Like, they had to put a metal pin in it. And then on top of that, it got infected. And then I had to have the pin pulled out and they nearly had to scrape away the bone marrow. And so it's stronger actually than this one.
It's an absolute miracle that he's even doing what he's doing today. Absolute.
So is that why you got such little T-Rex arms, is it?
That's it.
Stunted growth.
Little stumps.
It was literally like that. So this part of the arm was, it was, and he went, look, mum, and then realised what he had done and started screaming.
But do you know the craziest thing ever is that Lyndall broke her arm the exact same way. So you have the undershorts first, mum.
Yeah.
These protect your noodle.
And keep it on.
Yeah. You don't hit anything then. And then knee supports on the top. Always underneath the leggings so they don't slide down.
Yeah, and I could do with one of them on my busted knee.
Yeah.
So I don't know if Sonny's told you, but when he wears red, it's his go day.
Oh, okay.
Do you know why, mum? Why would I wear red on go day? Back to my childhood. Who was my hero when I was a kid?
Williams?
Tiger Woods.
Oh, of course.
He used to wear red on Sunday.
Your father really wanted to see you as a Tiger Woods, didn't he?
Where are you from? There's a fun fact that most people don't know about. Where's Sonny actually from?
I'm from Kiwi Land, New Zealand.
Mm-hmm.
And I was born and bred in Littleton, just outside of Christchurch. And then I went to England for 21 years and had Sonny and Jess. And then I, 16 years ago, returned back to New Zealand to do a bit of a journey of my own.
How good.
And now I'm probably going to be moving back here in November.
Mate, you just disappeared for about 15 minutes. Where'd you go?
Man, it was this like 80-year-old guy just pulled up out there trying to look for the mechanic and he was like, please will you get in the car and show me where it is?
Did he offer you any lollies in that outfit?
No, man, I don't know why.
Look at this. Would you let a stranger in your car like that?
Nah, he just needed help, so I just done my good deed for the day. He found the mechanic, be alright. He nearly crashed 3 times on the way to mechanic, which is no reason why he's going to the mechanics, but good on the lad. Can you do the haka, mum?
Yeah, I could do it, but I...
But she won't.
Can you do the haka, Sonny? Easy.
I'm just taking it steady today because if I have a build up on a weight and it doesn't feel that good, I just repeat it till it does feel good. So you're only ever adding weight when you feel confident enough to, which is sometimes quite good if you're just doing singles. It's about feeling it out.
But you can't do it in a competition, of course.
Well, you can't do it in a competition because you've only got a certain amount of time to warm up, but in training, one of the biggest mistakes people make is they run into the gym and they've got like an hour to do 6 exercises and they just rush through it even if it's feeling shit and it ends up becoming like completely pointless. Whereas like today, I may take an hour, but I know that every single lift I've been doing on this exercise has been deliberate. This is so much more about focus and technique. Although it's like an explosive strength sport, like the technique is so important. And for me, more than anything, that's what I think about when I'm building up. The weight, you don't even feel the weight because you're so conditioned to that element. You're more focusing on the technique and the feel of each lift, because that's what then gives you the confidence to take the next lift. If it feels right, if it's solid, stable in the catch, you're then ready to build up. You don't notice the weight. And like half the people that I train, I coach, like all the people I coach, to be honest, it's never strength that is the limiting factor for them. It's the fact that they haven't got either, they're not even moving well enough in order to get in the positions that you need to for weight lifting, or they haven't got the technique to the level where they can actually utilize their strength.
Oh, yeah. Film the mist, we've got to have some mist on here as well. It makes people feel good to know that you're human.
It doesn't make me feel good though, Mum. So I just always watch it back, see what I did wrong. Look how far I threw my shoulder.
Yeah, and your head was right back.
Yeah.
And you always go on about that.
You've
got to come straight up.
Yeah, exactly. Majority of the clients I have online, 70% of the women, and I'd say 70% of them are over the age of 35. Yeah, I have one guy that I coach. One of the ladies is at least 40, 43, and I have one of the guys is 63 that I coach.
And has he done it all his life, or has he just started?
No, he just got into CrossFit when he was like late in his life, like 50 maybe. And he smashes it. And he moves better than some of the younger kids that I coach, you know? People can think that weightlifting's like, oh, too old for that. But the weightlifting can be for anyone of any age if you master the technique first, you lift within your ego, within your means, and you move, focus on moving well. That was better, Mum.
Hit your knee?
Nah, that was better. It's just dusty because I'm not used to that a lot.
And I can't even get it off the ground. Come on,
Sonny, come on. A bit better.
What's the plan now, bro? You just obviously hit
a couple more singles at that and like refine at that weight. Like, it's a bit like what I did yesterday with the squats. I haven't done much snatching above 130, like volume. I've done like heavy one-off singles every 2 weeks at 150, but like you need to actually build confidence and refinement above that 85-90% sort of weight. So it's gonna be a lot more valuable than maybe snatching 140, than snatching 140 today, really, in my opinion.
You've mentioned straps two or three times. Is that getting to you a wee bit mentally?
Well, you can see that I'm tightening up because I'm coming onto my toes.
Yeah.
Look, way before I'm hitting my full extension. So it's technically for me, it's not good today at all. Like, I'm on my toes early, my shoulders are back behind the bar when I extend, but I'm getting away with it because of my speed. But like, that is not gonna fly when you get to 150. So like, I'm gonna do 2-3 more lifts, maybe at this 130, and try and focus on keeping my feet flat past the knee and keep my shoulders over. And if I can do 2 or 3 of that and see some improvement in position, then like I said, that's more valuable in today's session. There's a lot about that that's actually better. Like, the two things that I focused on were better, but I didn't see the whole lift of my head, so we'll go again.
Nice! Come on, confidence, finish it.
Come on, Zeus, come on.
That's right, yeah, 30. Well, either do 30, 35, 40, or 35, 40, 45. And then some like 70, 75, 80. So, over that. It just feels like not very fluid today. It's like all like.
Dusty. We're a bit dusty today.
Big ball.
So if you're gonna post a miss, you'll make it a big miss. He said he wouldn't even post 135 miss.
I didn't miss it much.
So what's the mindset between jumping from 35 to 40?
Well, to be honest, like the 35 for me, and not just discrediting 135 snatch, is good, but I've been snatching 150s lately, so 135 for me is like not that great a session. I come into it with my head thinking 140 snatch there I would have been happy with. So sometimes when you've like missed a couple of times and there's heart on the bar, the weight doesn't feel heavy, going up to the weight that you actually envisaged when you walked in at the start of the session can sometimes be just what it takes to get you to move on, because like I said, I know I'm strong enough to hit this weight.
So you've already psyched yourself for that weight, but not that.
Not the one on the way up. This is the thing. Like, and this part of the reason why I feel a lot of people screw up if they don't actually focus on the build up and give respect to every weight going up. That's an issue, you know.
And because you know you're good at it, it's only you're thinking about. You know you can lift it. It's technique. What you're doing differently.
Yeah. But you've also, at the same time, you've got to earn the right to add weight to the bar. So, fortunately. This is way under my PB, so I've got the right to snatch this.
Come on. Your mother's in the house.
Still there today, Mum.
With me.
I'll be alright, Mum. Oh, fuck's sake.
Hey! Why?
Hey! I must admit it looks very painful.
Sessions like this when someone has like a shit session, first thing they'll do is like, you know, you saw how G'd up I was when I come into this session. I was excited when I was coming to watch. I felt good. I was like, oh, I'm gonna definitely send like 150 coming in. And then it just didn't happen today. And equally how when you're feeling great and you have a shit session, it's the same reason why when you come in and you feel like shit and you have a great session, that you're like, why, how, what happened? And part of it comes down to expectation. I think sometimes when you come into a training session with such a high expectation, you can easily leave yourself walking out of the gym disappointed that you didn't meet your own expectation for that day. But a lot of the time when it does go bad, it's the time now where you're like, was it because I squatted yesterday? Was it because I only had one meal before training? Did I have too much sugar? Didn't get enough sleep last night because I was up early? Like, there's all these things, and sometimes it's not necessarily one reason as to why you may not perform on a given day, but it's only when you fail are you more inclined to actually reflect on what was the reason why. But you need to pay the same amount of attention to, if you have a good session, what was the things that happened on that day that could have been conducive to that being a good session, because that will reduce the amount of times you have a little dog session like I do and sat here wondering why. But you know what I always do, even though I fucking hate pulls, is finish off the session with this exercise that I still know is going to make me a better weightlifter, as much as I hate doing them. Get three
you
sets.
You say that in every video.
I know, but it's like, why is this guy who pulls so much?
And you've had an operation today, come on.
Oh yeah, sorry, that was all. The operation done me, drained my blood. Yeah, I'm low on blood cells.
You are cool.
No, lunch.
Must be something.
Embarrassed on YouTube. I already feel bad, you know, in two sets of pulls. Do you know what? You don't generally do too much high volume or heavy pulls around competition, or heavy squats really for volume, because it will fatigue you on those top end lifts. So this will probably be the last time I'll pull. I won't pull at all next week, just so I'm a little bit fresh for the day. Like, I wouldn't say I'm tapering for the competition, because it's just a little fun club competition, but I still want to feel fresh on the day and perform well for everyone's going to watch.
That's incredible.
Guys, you gotta join me for another big Friday. You gotta meet my mum, very special woman. We weren't super close for a long period of lives, but in the last 3 years, we made an extended effort to try and reconnect and get to know each other again. And she's such a hoot, and it's mad now meeting her as a woman and me as a man, and seeing how many similarities we have and how well we get on. And cool that she's come over again. Happy Mother's Day to everyone out there who's a mum. Make sure you buy your parents something nice if you haven't. And at least tell them you love them. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you next week for some big vlogs around the competition. I'm gonna be shitting myself next week. It's been a long time, like I said, since I've competed. So I wanna kind of give you guys an insight into what goes through my head. Ahead of competition, you're gonna see me squeeze into my Olympic suit, get all psyched up for the day, which is, yeah, it's gonna be a bit fun. So until then, I'm gonna enjoy this weekend with my mum. Big love.